You're welcome to PSLE Max. Let's look at some tips chapter-wise in P6 Max that would be useful towards the PSLE exam. This is the second part of the tips and tricks video. Let's start with algebra. Algebra is using letters to represent numbers whose value is unknown. Algebra is not new to P6. You have been doing them from primary 1. Just that you used a box or a blank for a variable instead of a letter like X or Y. In a problem, the same letter must not be used to represent different variables. Also, each variable value remains the same in that problem. When no sign is in between a number and a letter in an equation, it stands for multiplication. For example, 3y means it is 3 times y. Add the variable parts and the constant parts separately. For example, 4x plus 5 plus 3x minus 2 is equal to 4x plus 3x is 7x and 5 minus 2 is 3. So the answer is 7x plus 3. It does not become 10x. Similarly, when substituting value for a variable, follow the Dmas rule, except when cases like 40 divided by 5y. Here the 5y is together. So the answer should be equal to 8 by y and not 8y. Don't do 40 divided by 5 first, which is 8, and then times y. This is 8 by y. Similarly, when solving for problem sums, x minus 10 and 10 minus x are different. So be cautious while reducing an equation and solving for x. Next, let's come to fractions. For addition and subtraction within fractions, make the denominator common. It should be the least common multiple of the two denominators. For multiplication within fractions, just multiply the numerators together and multiply the denominators together. For division by another fraction, inverse the divisor, that means the second fraction, and then multiply the numerators together and the denominator together. Coming to decimals, multiplying by 1000, move the decimal place right by 3 places. For example, 1.23 times 1000 should give us 1230. Similarly, when dividing, say for example dividing by 100, move the decimal point to the left by 2 places. Example, 354.6 divided by 100 should be 3.456. When dividing a decimal number by long division, which we would probably do in paper 1, double check the position of the decimal point on the quotient to be same as the dividend. Let's now come to percentage. Percent means per 100. So 100% of x is the x itself. 1 to 99% of x is less than x, and 101% and more of x is more than x. So when you get an answer, say 80% of x, make sure that 80% of x is less than x. Percentage problem sums can be solved using fractions or taking 100% as 100u. Any method is acceptable. Let's look at some of the common mistakes while doing percentage problems. Do not add up two percentages blindly. Check for their 100% or the whole. The whole could be different in value. Only if they are referring to the same whole, percentages can be added. A percent of the before or percent of the after, the wholes could be different. There again, we cannot add or subtract the percentage. Problem sums where some percent of the remainder underline the word remainder. Find the remainder first, and that becomes the whole for the next calculation. Another common mistake is 20% decrease from 100 drops to 80, but a 20% increase from 80 does not become 100, but it becomes 96. 20% increase on 100 only will become 120. Now let's come to ratios. Always maintain the given ratio. When multiplying, make sure you multiply both the sides by the same number. Read the question carefully. If the answer is asked for A is to B or B is to A, and answer accordingly. So the common mistakes in ratio would be You cannot add or subtract two ratios or within ratios. Their actual values would be different. Always provide your answer in the simplest form, even if not mentioned in your question. Next, coming to rate. Convert to correct units that you are going to use throughout that problem. For the volume rate problem sums, 1 liter per minute is equal to 1000 centimeter cube per minute, which is equal to 1000 milliliters per minute. Problems on work done per time. For example, when two people do the same work, it is always faster than being done by one person. Remember that and check your answers. P.S. Since the concept of speed is not tested this year in 2020 PSLE, speed is just an extension of rate. So expect a problem in rate for sure, either with volume rate or work done rate or even both. This is just my expectation. Next, coming to angles. Some of the angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Some of the angles in a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Diagonal of a square makes 45 degrees with the sides. And similarly, when doing questions on angles, identify all the sets of parallel lines and their intersecting lines and mark the angles that are equal. A parallelogram has two sets of parallel lines, but unlike a parallelogram, the two non-parallel sides of a trapezium have no related angles, sides, that is no relation between the two sides of the trapezium. Next, coming to the metric conversions, make sure your conversions are all in your fingertips. 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams. Length, 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters. 1 meter is 100 centimeters. Volume, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. And 1 cc or 1 centimeter cube is same as 1 milliliter. Finally, coming to a few more topics. Assumption method or set problem. For example, certain problem sums that involve, say for example, 50 cent coins and 20 cent coins, where the total number of coins and the total value of all the coins is given, it should be done by assumption method, which is just an extension of guess and check. But if the relationship between the number of 50 cent coins and the number of 20 cent coins is given, like a ratio or a fraction, it is a set problem. So identify the correct approach to do the problem. Another common mistake is misusing the value of the diameter for radius and vice versa. So check before your calculation. In area problems with circles of different sizes, when radius doubles, area does not double, but it becomes 4 times. When area of a square is given, use square root function in the calculator to find its signs. Do not divide by 2. For paper 1, learn the simple square numbers until 144. 12 times 12 is 144. 11 times 11 is 121. 8 times 8 is 64. So when the area is given, you know one of the sides of the square. Similarly, when volume of a cube is given, use the cube root function in the calculator. Keeping all these tips in mind, good luck to all the kids who are taking PSLE this year. Hope you liked this video. Please subscribe to this channel for more problem sums. If you have a specific question that you would like to see a video on, please post it in the comment section. Thank you.